it shall become possible for you. Receive power. Receive power. Power to defy sickness. Power to defy death. Receive it now. Every chariot after your destiny, all these double pursuers, die. The devil must go down. His God must go down. The powers of death must go down. And you will see his glory. You will see his glory. You will see his wonder. God make a difference. In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. First Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. First Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. Thank you, Lord Jesus. They had no temptation taking you, but such as common to man. So all temptations are common. All temptations. There's no one superior to other. But God is faithful. It shows us the character of God that in the midst of temptations that someone is faithful. He does not fail. His word is constant. Whom he will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able. What a God. What a mighty God. That what you are going through now, because he's faithful, his character is his faithfulness. He cannot deny himself. He cannot afford to give you what is beyond you. Because he's faithful. He knows what you can take and what you cannot take. So he gives you what is not beyond you. So what you're going through right now in your various families, as individuals, is what you're able to take. If your husband is misbehaving, your wife is misbehaving, your children are misbehaving, it's what they're able to take. Because God in his faithfulness, the Bible says he sees the end from the beginning and beginning from to the end. So, as a matter of fact, God is like a film director. The film director must have written a scene, finished it. Everything is completed before he started casting. So he has seen the end. Just like you watching the film, you are watching last week, 2 weeks ago, last month. Somebody else watching it for the first time, you just be laughing. This film, man. Why are you laughing? Because you have seen the end. So the same thing applies to God. Put that thing, I'm not done yet. Put it back. Put the scripture back. Amen. And pay attention. Put the scripture back. Hallelujah. So like a movie director who has seen the end of sin, end of a drama. So he tells the cast what to do, and he's there laughing and say, I know the end already. That's the same way God is. And because of that, he's faithful, because he's able to see the end. So he gives you what you're able to be. Before you were born in your mother's womb, he already knew you. He programmed you. He knew when you're going to go through a certain temptation, maybe down the road, 20 years down the road, 30 years down the road, something will happen to you. Look at the beauty of it. The Bible says, but will with the temptation also make a way of escape. That's what touched me. Say that this God who knows the end from the beginning, he has known that when you are 20 years old, 30 years old, something will happen to you. But he has already made a provision for escape. when I read that, I say, God, what a man, what kind of God is this? That when he programmed you, you know that you are bound to have some issues along the line. So what did he do? He make a way. Don't take it off until I say you take it off, please. You're interrupting my sequence. Did we there until I say take it off, okay? But thank you. So it will also make a way. So he has made. So that word MKE is not, it's different from setting. No, we say whoever's God sets free, set free indeed. Setting free is different from making. Making is like a manufacturing something, you know, putting things and taking the raw material and making it to a finished product. So it tells us here that God who made us has also made a way. He created a way, he manufactured a way of escape. So he has put a momentum and a velocity onto a certain event or situation that will take you out of temptation. So what you are going through now will not kill you.
I said, what you are going through now will not kill you. I say it will not kill you. It will kill your husband. It will kill your wife. It will kill your children because he has made a way, make like a manufacturer. He has manufactured it. A way of escape. Give me that situation. I want to read the last part. That ye may be able to bear it. Can I take it off now? That ye may be able to. He has made a way of escape. Praise God. That's why I know there's nothing you are going through now that you are not coming out. I see you coming out of it. I don't care what the devil says, what your neighbor says, what your in-law says, what your children say, what your wife say, husband say. All I know, you are coming out. I say you are coming out. I say you are coming out. I don't care what doctors say. I don't care what your friends say. I say you are coming out. God has made a way of escape, even for the Holy Ghost fellowship. Whatever we are going through now, that's a way of escape. I see you escaping. I see you escaping your enemies. I see you escaping disease. I see you escaping sicknesses. I see you escaping problems and difficulties. I see God making sure you are free. I see you free. I see you free. I see you free. God has made a way of escape. So go and tell your friends, I'm not stuck here. I'm not going to last here. This is just a whipping may endure for a night. A time comes where money comes. Where I will lie, because God has already made a way for me to escape from this temptation, to escape from this problem. So I will not stay here till I die. I am going out. I am coming out of it. Things will come to good. Things will come out well. Things will make up. Things will come out well. In the name of Jesus, we serve the true living God. You were the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God has done it for them, given them the way of escape, it's your turn. You escape that temptation. You escape that trouble. You escape that sickness. You escape that problem. You escape that palaver. God is on your side. God is on your side. God is on your side. Shout I know it all. God has made a way of escape. Anyone that tells you that this thing you like, it will kill you, tell the person, no. God, Bible says, that's what I say, God is faithful. That's the one that touched me most. His faithfulness compels him to create a way of escape. God is faithful. Am I making sense? Very faithful. So don't let me deceive you. That's what you are going through now as individual, as a family, as a fellowship, that is not common. It's common. It's everywhere. People have problems here and there. But one thing is faithfulness won't allow him to do is to leave you stranded. You will not be stranded though. I say you can't be stranded. You cannot be stranded. You cannot be stranded. Shout us the way out. Thank you, precious Father. Be thou exalted, be thou glorified. In Jesus' precious name. People shout it, be amen. Amen. Come on, clap for Jesus, who has given you a way of escape. Amen. So let it be your slogan. When someone tell you, oh, sister, brother, you have been going through this for too long, tell you, say, God has made a way of escape. I must surely come out. I say, watch and see. I'm coming out. I don't care if the exam you're writing, you're coming out of it. Gallantly successful. Am I making sense? Shout, I know it, sir. Hallelujah. So I want to thank God again very quickly to those who are helping us to keep us here. Amen. I will not stop thanking you every week. I'm serious. I'm committed to thanking you. Yeah, I'm above thanking God who gave you the provision, because everything we own, everything we have, the work we do, if you like, do 24 hours work, it belongs to God. Praise God. So, and you are benevolent enough to say, oh, you know what? I'm going to take out of my sweat to make sure we are here to worship him. May God bless you, regard. Some of you work like after fellowship, you are working, you wake up in the early morning, take your children, take family. You are just working hard. See, go to work and still sacrifice towards the fellowship. You think God will not reward you? Bible says he's faithful. Then time I remember that quality of God, I say, he's faithful. He's done already. Because God cannot deny himself. Praise the Lord. God cannot lie. That's one thing. Why will you lie? Are you going to kill him? Praise God. Where is he even far away? We can't even touch him. So why will he lie? So when he says he's faithful, he's faithful.
take it to the bank and cash it. Hallelujah. So may God bless you. Very good. I want to say those of us who have not started contributing, please do. Some of you didn't contribute throughout the seed time, everything you just cross over. You're just looking at us. Hallelujah. It's time to start doing, not to look. Praise God. Tell somebody stop looking and start doing. Hallelujah. So please, this February should not pass you by. Donate some, do something to keep us going here. You know, amen. And we are already going towards the middle of the month. So if God, if you have not done anything, please quickly help us. And God bless you mightily in Jesus' mighty name. What a wonderful 7 days fast, dry fast. It was powerful. And then God began to tell us that we have entered our season of manifestation. That's what gave birth to that theme for the month. It's our season. He said our season. He didn't say this is our season. Our season of manifestation. It was corporate. So corporate in the sense that because we have been through these times of fasting and prayer. You know, I've taught us about Chronos and Kairos before. That you can Kairos on time. That when things are going normal, you can choose to Kairos it. That will make it a special moment. Make it an opportune time. Make it God's own sovereign time. Make it a prophetic time by yourself. Praise God. Because in the first place, God has given us a general manifestation at the arrival of Jesus. At the dispensation of grace, God came down to give us a special move. So we're in the move since the time Jesus died on the cross of Calvary and resurrected. The church generally all over the world is in a special dispensation, special manifestation, special move. Our special move began. Unlike Old Testament, when the Holy Ghost come upon certain individuals and use them and leave them, use them and leave them, use them and leave them, and come back and go out, come back and go out. So in our time, Jesus came and died and resurrected. The Holy Ghost came. Since the Holy Ghost came, he stayed. So that there qualifies us that the church is in a special season of manifestation. Generally speaking, am I communicating? So, but even though it's general, it's generic and general, you and I can kairos it to make it special at our time. So as a fellowship, we decide to kairos it by putting 7 days dry fast. It's a kairosing. It's making it, though we know that we're in a moment of special dispensation, moment of grace. Generally, the church is basking in the grace period, in the time when it is God's own favorite time for the church. Yes, we know that, because Christ has come and died. But it won't just happen on the plateau of gold. It won't just happen on the lamps. You have to do something about it. You have to take the advantage of it. So we took the advantage. I began to fast and say, God, please, in case you are passing, we are here. You see, God is too busy. God is too busy. Too busy. Too busy. Does not mean can't see everything. But you need to do something to attract his attention. Bible says, blind Bartimaeus shouted, "Oh, son of David, that I may see." Immediately called it out. Jesus passed, so he saw him. Of course, it's God. He's a deity. He must have seen blind Bartimaeus. He did not pay attention to him. But as soon as he shouted, "Son of David," heaven turned. So, friends, that is blind Bartimaeus was able to kairos the moment. But I saw Christ pass, he didn't say anything. But Jesus, but blind Bartimaeus shouted, "Jesus, the son of David, come and kairos my time." If I can use that word. And Jesus said, "Who is that?" And Bible says he's too still. So you can make heaven to stand still on your behalf if you know how to kairos your moment. Am I communicating? So we as a fellowship, we start to carry the moment by waiting on the Lord for seven days dry fast. We are telling heavens, please, let heaven stand still. Let Jesus stand still. Let God stand still for our cases, for our situation. Our case is very special and urgent. We carry it. And I hear God telling me our season of manifestation. Specifically, no general, but we're talking about specific, that the Holy Ghost in our season of manifestation. Am I communicating? So we're the good timing. When the timing of God, when the chaos moments, wherein each of us can tap into this manifestation and make it personal. Make it personal. Personal, personal. You can chaos it and make it personal. You can be people cashing on things. Am I communicating? When God gives this, when God comes to your streets, it's your neighborhood. What do? You tap into it. "Hi, Jesus, I'm here." Praise the Lord. He can't come to a neighborhood. You are looking at him. "I heard that Jesus came to my neighborhood. He's come and gone." Really? He came and gone. You didn't know he came to your neighborhood. You need deliverance. So when he comes to a neighborhood, everyone must catch him. You have to seek your head out and take your own. If you don't, he will just pass. He passed blind Bartimaeus until he shouted. "Ah, I
see you attracting heavens. I see your husband attracting heavens. I see your wife attracting heavens. I see your family attracting heavens. I see you attracting heaven in your case. Shut my case, is urgent. My case is urgent. I see God visiting you. I see God touching you. I see God touching your husband. I see God touching your wife. I see God touching your children. I see God touching the works of your hand. I see God touching your exams. I see God touching your mother, touching your father, touching your siblings. I see God kairos in your moments. The Mr. Kronos, Zobragado Shabaya. This is our season of manifestation as a fellowship. But individually, you can cash in and say, God, I am cashing in. I am tapping into this manifestation. I am making my personal case. I'm making my personal situation. God visit me. God visit my husband. God visit my wife. God visit my children. God, I need you.
Friends, don't allow this moon pass by. Because this is a prophetic moment, and that word for season means prophetic times, prophetic moment. That's our word for seasons, prophetic times, prophetic moment. Now, we are prophesied based on what we kairos. And God is saying our season or manifestation is not left for individuals to cash in, to tap in. Am I communicating? So, if you allow this to pass, it might just pass like that. But be a typology of blind Bartimaeus. You shout at them. I don't say you are blind. I say a typology of blind Bartimaeus. Who needs God's help? Who needs his eye to be opened? I say, God, I may see. Don't let Jesus pass you by. This moment is a moment of our season of manifestation. So individually, when you go to pray at night with your husband and wife and children, go to pray with your family, oh God, it has been declared that Holy Ghost is our time season of manifestation. Oh God, visit my family, visit my husband, visit my wife. I tap in into this manifestation. Friends, I pray by the end of February, you will see God's hand. You will see God's favor. You will see God's grace. His grace will manifest upon you. His power will manifest upon you. There will be diversity of move of God. Those that need healing will receive the healing. Those that need deliverance will receive the deliverance. Those that need restoration will receive the restoration. Those who are carrying bodies will be lifted. Those that are carrying yoke will be broken. Diverse kinds of move of God will happen to you this season of February. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive your own turn for manifestation. Receive your own turn for manifestation. Now, in the name of Jesus, shout out, receive it. Very possible for you to miss it. And very, very possible to miss, very possible for you to miss it. Friends, let you know that God deals with individuals according to their hunger. Let me just quickly say this. I'm not even going to the scripture. I'm just preaching that God is helping me. Let me just quickly say, there are four things to know that God is around you. Four things. Number one, when you have hunger. When you suddenly see a sudden hunger for his presence, you can't just miss his presence. Masu kataba, there are three or four, but there are three or four things that shows you your manifestation is just by the way. But into catching, when you see all of a sudden you have sudden hunger for God, for God's presence, you just have a sudden hunger for God. You need to pray more than ever before. If you are praying like 30 minutes before, you are praying for 1 hour. If you are praying for 1 hour, pray for 1 hour 30 minutes now. You just have this hunger. You can't just sustain his presence. You can't just but pray. You can't just long for his presence. You are hungry. Undying hunger. That shows your manifestation is around. Just hunger. You can't wait for fellowship to come. You can't wait to go to fellowship. You can't wait to wait for Bible study. You can't wait to just attend a place of prayer meetings. You are hungry. But if you are like a desical, you don't care. Whatever will be. I'm sorry. Manifestation is not close by at all. Am I making sense? God must have a word preparing you for your manifestation. Am I making sense? Because if God just put something in your lap, like someone be given $1 billion, you faint. So, what God is to prepare you by giving you a hunger, to let you know I'm about to visit you. Because what I'm about to do is going to be so heavy. If I bring it to you, you're not prepared, you might collapse. You might be to misfire, not be to handle the move or manage the move of God. Because God wants to manage it properly, he prepares you by giving you hunger. When you have such undying hunger, you see God telling you, I'm about to come, about to touch your mother, about to touch your husband, about to touch your father, about to touch your children. That undying hunger will stay with you. Number two, how do you know manifestation about to come? When you have a staying power, despite what you are going through,
despite what is not working well around you, you are staying. Say, God, I don't know what to do without you. You are like my breath. I'm so dependent on you. I cannot go do without you. It's all you. I know all I know. You are so dependent on God. God, I don't know somebody else. I don't even know me. All I know is you. I'm so dependent on you. But I lean on you. I cannot do without you. You are so dependent on God that you don't care about plan A, plan B, plan C. Yours all one plan I have is God. God is my plan. So dependent on him. Come rain, come sun. When things don't happen very well, you say, oh God, I know you alone and you alone. I know. I'm not going anywhere else. I'm not going to visit happiness. I'm going to visit any man. Man will not help me. My parents won't help me. I know one man that can help me. His name is called Jesus. And you lean on him. It's called his staying power. You are staying despite your odds. You are staying despite all problems. Say, God, you are me. If you kill me, kill me.
If you kill me, kill me. Esther says, if I perish in this course, let me perish. That's a man whose manifestation is around the corner, just there for him, or even close by to you. So, God, I don't know somebody else. It's you I know, God, that deal with me, heal me, deliver me. Deliver me, help me. You stay. Even though you don't see, you stay. Even though it's not come, you also come, you still stay. Not when Tessalon will be saying, you know, this fellowship, self. This fasting and prayer, self. Every time he says you should fast and pray. That means manifestation is not close by at all. You are still far. So near but yet far. That's what we say. So near but yet far. So near to glory. It's somebody who is bat in the oil but yet you are dry. It's a very serious situation. Bat in the oil but dry. Your oil is so much around you but you are so dry because you cannot be able to feel these conditions. I see you getting there. I see you staying power. I see you staying power in your life. Receive it now. Despite ups and down. Despite whatever is around you, but you are staying. You are staying. You are staying. Kakaraka. That shows manifestation is around the corner. Number three. Oh God, this burden. I have a burden for the people, a burden for the fellowship, a burden for the people, a burden from family. You stay. You see whatever is not around your family, but you cannot go. The burden cannot leave you. You see people die in the family. You cannot see, so stop the burden. The burden keeps coming upon you. You are the only savior for the family. You keep having this burden on you. Oh God, when will you save my family? When will you save my husband? This foundation, this evil, come around my family. Where will that be? Where will you deliver me? You are so burdened. Every time you go, my family, oh my husband, oh my wife, this burden is too much. Oh God, lift this burden away. You are always saddled with burden. You are burden for the family, burden for your husband, burden for the children, full of burden. Not somebody else who say, whatever we be, it doesn't matter. They die, they live. That means you are so close, but yet far. We don't care. A man, a woman who does not care about what is going in the family, going around him, is a man who's not burdened. But you care so much, and not just say, oh, I care. No. If you just say that's not the end of it, you need to be burdened. And burden will lead to the passion. Passion will lead to fasting and prayer. It leads to special times of prayer because you are so burdened. It's weighing you down. You cannot but leave this burden and you are crying. Ladies and gentlemen, when you carry such burden, this is a man that God looking for to take the city. You are burdened to take over the city and take over the family. And God will say, give me my family or I die. You are so burdened. If I die, let me die. But I need my family to stay. They say your husband, your wife will die. People die every 10 years. You say, no. Save my family or kill me, Lord. Oh, give me my family or I die. Burden. It's a man of burden that God gives his city to, his family to. A man in Scotland, I heard a story. Man in Scotland, he said, God, give me Scotland or I die. I heard a story that, I hope I'm right, that throughout the time of that man, even up to, I don't know whether it's story, but I'm be serious, right? But anyway, I heard that alcohol stopped being sold in Ireland. Because one man said, give me this land or I die. Am I communicating? Friends, God does not give burden to people who don't care. Am I communicating? And God does not give families or cities territory to those who don't care. Friends, burdened men are city takers. Burdened men are family takers. You are burdened. And that shows that coming concern, no matter how far it is, that your manifestation is drawing near. Am I communicating? That shows the glory of God is coming around you. Very soon you tap into it. And this is a carousel moment, the moment of a manifestation. I see you tap into it. I see it working for you. I see it working for you. Shout, I've been to this manifestation. It will not miss me. It won't pass me by. Tap into the manifestation. All of you on YouTube, Facebook, receive God's manifestation. Receive God's own timing. Receive God's grace over your life. That's a way of escape. Shala Babaya. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Peter was exalted, Peter glorified. Shakatalabaya. Zubregebo Shabaya. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. Give me the next verse. I'm already done with my preaching itself. Well, let's do something. Look, I'll look up very soon. Bible says, in everything there is a season. In everything. Mark that word. Everything. Scripture is too deep. Friends, anyone that tells you there are things that is impossible or impossible, can't see that thing like that, for God to do, tell the person a lie. Bible says to everything, every. Did you go to school? Hallelujah. I know a lot of you are graduates. But when you say every means nothing missing. Everything is included. Very inclusive. Everything. All things. So, whatever you are going through is part of the every. I don't care what you are going through. Let it be something impossible, difficult. You know, somebody is dying somewhere. He said to everything that is a season. So, don't tell me, you see, brother, my case is so special. My situation is very special. There's no solution to it. There's nothing, no way out. Bible says, no, that's not true. Say to everything there is a season. Amen. It's not like saying, okay, well, this year there will be dry season this year, next year will be dry season. No. Every year there will be dry season. And there will be rainy season. Praise God. There will be summer. If I pursue and look towards it, there will be summer. It must come and go. Season changes. Amen. But because at this point in time, it looks as if things are not working well. Because it could be dry season, it could be rain season, it could be anything whatsoever. But there is season for everything. Am I coming to you? And purpose is attached to a time. So my topic tonight, because our theme for the month is understanding our season of manifestation. That's our theme for the month of February. I started introducing it to us last week. So today we'll go to another, of course, and everything that we have topics for everything. Amen. So I want to go into another topic today, which I want to title, Anything is Possible. Anything. Praise God. Anything is what? Possible. We serve God of all possibilities. So to them that believe, all things are possible. All things. And the Christ tells us that everything is a season. Am I communicating? Well, it could be season of dryness, season of rain season, season of whatever it is. It could be different kinds of seasons. Praise God. But that must be seasons. So, and our word for season, it means kairos moment. Season means kairos or special time or prophetic time. That's our word for season. Amen. Physically, we see the season of events being unfolded at a certain period of time. Events being unfolded at a certain period of time. It's a physical, that's what we call season. When events are unfolded at a certain period of time, it's called season. For example, the event of raining. Rain falls within certain times, certain months. And after then, there'll be winter. After then, there'll be this, there'll be that. So these are certain period of time called season. So time is a unit of season. So times are seasons. Times put together are seasons. So which means every time you see there's a purpose attached to it, and a series of time making up a period is a season. Am I coming together? So the same way, in the realm of the spirit, seasons of a man is a time of his special moments. A time of his special manifestation. A time of his special move. when God comes to move in a special way, other than other times. Praise God. Sometimes it could be a dry season for you. Sometimes it could be a rainy season for you. Amen. If it's dry, that means God is preparing you for the wet days. Every time you see a dry season, rainy season is about to come. Am I coming again? So, during that season, it's a time for preparation. A time for special preparation. For example, we just went through a dry season of fasting and prayer for some of you. Know what I'm by dry? Dry. You were fasting, no food, no water. That means dry. That's what we call it, dry season. That means it's a dry season for you. But after dry season, what comes after then? Rainy season. Am I getting it? It is what God, he said, seed time and harvest shall not cease. God has prepared times and seasons in his own accord. So if dry season in your life, rain is coming. So that's why you should not give up at all. Because anything is possible. Anything. Don't say because you're going through dry season, now, oh, rain, no, you won't die in it. Right in that season, you make a way for you. Who will escape? And you enter your rain season. Am I communicating? Because seasons are transitional. You transition to seasons. And when one season is over, you pray for another season again. You don't just remain in one season because God shifts people from level to level. God moves people from one glue to another. So once it is over, it takes another season. Let me just say this. It might be, I'm not trying to be negative, but when a rain season has come, it's about to go. That means the what God wants to do in your life that time is getting over. In other words, God is going to prepare you for another level. God does not stay in one place. He moves. God is a progressive God. Am I communicating? Pay attention to what I'm saying now. God is very progressive. He's very revelational. When God gives you a particular rainy season, particular beautiful season, at his time, we make all things beautiful. When all things are becoming beautiful for you, all of a sudden, you begin to see a shift of dryness. I see you are drifting to dryness. It could be a business that is working, moving, booming, booming. All of a sudden, people are owing you here and there. Your receivables and everything is getting lower. Things are working. It's a little shift. You're shifting to some little kind of dryness for a purpose. Maybe you have a family and everything's working well. All of a sudden, your daughter starts misbehaving. Oh, I want person I'm dating. You didn't even expect that to happen. You're already dating again. Eh? In my own house, dating who? Praise God. You want the person is behaving. If you want to go and elope with the person. No, I'm not coming. That's times of dryness. You say, oh God, you know I fast and pray. You know I do this one. Why my child doing this? You know, I take my children. I take my daughter. And you are seeing in your very eyes that somebody is trying to date you, whatever, and cause problems. That's a moment of dryness. The Bible says, remember, you make a way of what? Escape. It could be your studies. Things are not going well. You are making AA, most of you are making C. What happened? I'm studying. What's going on? Dry season is cheapening. And why God allows it? Because he wants to shift you to another season of rain. So you cannot remain in dry season forever. God introduced dry season for you to prepare again. Prepare again in a fresh way for the next one. Am I correct? So life is all about preparation, beauty. Preparation, beauty. Preparation, beauty. Because God is transitional. God is progressive. God is revelational. God is revolutionary. Am I making sense? So when you see some dryness around you, don't say, oh God, why me? Why me? I'm fasting for 7 days. Don't say that. Say, God, thank you. I know you are about to shift me again. You are about to take me to something higher. I will not give up. I have a staying power. I will not give up from this. You that did it for me yesterday, I had a wet season, a very beautiful season. I'm experiencing some dryness, some little inconvenience. I know I'm not staying here. I know I'm just transitioning. I will take me to something higher and higher. God, I give you praise. I worship you. You need to worship and lay that before you and say, God, thank you. Because I'm moving to the next level. Because you said you would take me from one glory to another. Friends, in between one glory to another, there is a dryness in it. There are times of preparation in it. That's where people fall. That's where people give up. Oh, this beautiful family, everything is going well. All of a sudden, husband is misbehaving. All of a sudden, wife is misbehaving. Oh, everything is going well. Nobody has been sick. All of a sudden, somebody becomes sick. And so God, I believe in healing power. I believe in healing miracle. Why is this person sick? Why am I going? And I pray nothing is happening. Oh God, where are you? Oh God, where are you? And so some people, they give up. Some people have a high expectation when they come to fellowship to receive their healing. Amen? And after a while, healing is not coming the way it's supposed to, they leave.
Why some come, they receive their healing, they also leave.
Am I communicating? So two of them are in error. Very much in error. The one that leave because there is no miracle yet, Bible says at his own time, you make all things what? Beautiful. I've been asking some questions. I say, those of you have been running around here and there, meeting people here and there, have you received your healing? Not yet. Ask somebody 2 days ago. I know you have been running around. You say, I watch this, I go there, I go here. I say, all this why? Have you believed in God for miracles? Say, yes. Have you received so far? He said, no. I said, yeah, because at God's own time, we make all things beautiful. I said, because you are trusting God for healing, and God said, you give it to you. Because remember, when he made you in the spirit, he already prepared everything for you. He made a way of escape. And he said that this year, 2023, in June, 6th of June, you receive something special. And then you are going to run around to receive it on the 6th of June, 6th of April. He won't give it to you. Am I communicating? Please get me very right. He won't give it to you because he has already made that time. The 6th of June is your day of beauty. And you are trying to force him to give it to you in April 6th. Am I communicating? Praise God. We know what God will do rather. God will bring you around hunger, around burden, because your manifestation is coming closer, 6th of June. So 6th of April, 6th of May, 6th of, he bring around hunger, burden, because something about to happen 6th of June. So there's no amount of running around that will force him to do it earlier. I'm making sense. So where you are is enough for your miracle. He told Abraham, says, from where you are, say, look. He saw everywhere. Say, that's out. So when you see somebody who receives a miracle, that means it's his time. Not because that person is special. Am I making sense? That's God's own time. Is it possible for you to miss your time? Yes. It's possible. If you're not in the right place, you will miss your time. And that is where you go and pray and fast and bring it back. The Bible says, redeem your time. That means the time has gone, you are buying it back. Am I making sense? Because it has already passed. Your time for manifestation passed, you missed it. You were not in the church or in fellowship that time. You were not praying. You were not fasting. You were busy going to club and enjoying yourself. And the time, 6th of June, came and passed. You didn't know. So Bible now say, it's a redeeming the time. When you realize you are falling behind, your time for miracle has passed. You're now plugging again. And so God, show me mercy. Show me mercy. I'm sorry. I didn't tap into it. You need to pray and fast. As you are fasting, give yourself a prayer of fasting and dryness. You are buying back the time again. And then you now go to a miracle service and it happens. Oh, I went to some place. It didn't happen. When I came, it happened. You just bought it. Am I communicating? Because it passed, but you bought it back. Am I communicating? Because that's your time. Am I making sense? So, another person again who comes and receives healing and leaves, you're also in error. Because as you receive it, there are greater things to come. God's own plan for you is not to end up healing. He said, I'll give you the Holy Ghost. It's not just healing. God's ultimate plan is not for you to be healed. Because healing is just a camel case. Am I making sense? His plan is holistic. The agenda of God is so big. It's not just healing. It's not a miracle. He wants to be used. It's possible that there is somebody who is being used in your town, okay, that has been messing around, or somebody is about to, maybe the person has gotten old, is about to die, and God is preparing you to take over the move of God in that community. So you coming for healing is a camel case. Because where God is taking you to is to be an agenda, an agent of change in your community. I'm giving an example. So you are looking at the healing of your leg, that you are feeling pain, God is looking at you to take over the move. Am I making sense? And you have been saying, oh God, heal me. Oh God, heal me. Oh God, heal me. God say, I know I'm going to heal you, but if I heal you now, you run away. Get to the community. Get to the community. When you go to the community where I send you, then healing will come. Because it will attract healing. Your office attracts healing. Your assignment attracts healing. I'm making sense. I'm trying to be practical this evening. This is night. I'm making sense. Very practical. Your assignment attracts healing. A lot of people have not received healing because they're not in the assignment. They're not in primary calling. They're moving around, doing things, whatever they're doing. Chasing money everywhere. And God is busy telling you, my daughter, my son, come back. Come back. And you are there. It's not for you to come and focus on God. You're moving around, looking for everywhere to go and look for prophecy. Meanwhile, your move, God is telling you, come back to committee, be the head of the committee. I want to use you for a move. And once you enter there, your healing will come automatically. But you're busy running around. Eventually, nothing happens. And then you that left because of healing is just a way of wooing. God has a way of wooing people. God woos. That's a man woos a woman. Do you know that? When God wants to take your attention, he'll give you a small healing. Woo! Glory! Hallelujah! And when that God healed me, knowing that God is wooing, God is calling you to a deeper experience. You now begin to run and say, oh God, thank you. And after they now begin to chase dollar, begin to do work, instead of doing 8 hours work, you're doing 24 hours work. They ask you, sir, sister, how far? Let me see fellowship. No, nah, man, that's one place they raise money. They gave us a raise of $100. So healing you receive was God wooed you to himself for a greater thing to do, to be done. But you are, because of healing, you ran away. And guess what will happen? You have opened the room for attack. A bigger one. That when it strikes you, oh my God. Bible says 7 more demons will come. Amen? Devil is wicked though. Devil has the word distracting you. Not only through sin, what you call sin. It can distract you with your strength or your weakness. Am I making sense? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So friends, anything is what? Possible. Why you in a dry season? The rainy season is about to come. And then when you see a little bit, any kind of dryness, it should be an opportunity for you to start going deeper into God. Say, God, thank you. I'm about to go to higher levels. Every dry season you see is an introduction to a higher manifestation. I see you getting there. I see you getting to higher manifestation. I see a higher manifestation. I see a higher manifestation. Receiving now. Receiving now. Receiving now. In the name of Jesus, we serve it to a living God who is the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God has done it for them, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. I say it's your turn. Receiving now. In the name of Jesus, shut out a seven to everything that is a season. It tells you clearly that anything is possible. Everything is possible. It does not matter what you are going through right now. What matters is God in there. Is God involved? If God is involved, your season is changing. Your season is changing. Your season is changing. I say your season is changing. That season of sickness is changing. That season of deliverance is going to go higher level of release of God. That season of dryness is changing to witness to the glory of God coming upon your life in the name of Jesus. I see God blessing you. I see God lifting you. I see God lifting you. I see God harvesting special things concerning your life in the name of Jesus. Friends, season is a special moment when you expect to harvest. Harvest, harvest, harvest. When you harvest what you have sown. So some of us, we have sown in prayer. Those of you who didn't do 7 days, at least you tried your best to do 30 days. See, to whatever you did, there was an investment. So season of manifestation is a time for harvesting. And I see you harvesting in a special way. I see harvest coming your 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 way. In the name of Jesus, receive your harvest. Receive miracle harvest. Receive signs and wonders harvest. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus, we serve it to a living God who is the same yesterday, the same today, the same forevermore. If God has done it for others, it's your turn. You don't have 2 heads. You have 1 head. You don't have 4 legs. You have 2 legs. You don't have 4 hands. You have 2 hands. Like others who receive miracles, it's your turn. I say it's your turn. If God has done it for A, he will do it for B. If God has done it for B, he will do it for C. Because you are also a child of God. You are also a daughter of God. Your case is cannot be a different one. Rather, it will make a difference in your life. God will make a difference in your life. In the name of Jesus, shout out of seven now. Jump on your feet, it's time to pray. God will make a way of escape. Does not matter what you're going through. Anything is possible. Anything can be is possible. God can do anything. God can do anything. Zobragado Shabaya. This is your time. Your time has come. The time for your husband has come. The time for your wife has come. The time for your children has come. Time for your parents have come.
God can do anything. God can do anything. God can do anything. Everything is possible to them that believe it. Everything is possible to them that believe it. Everything is possible. God can do anything. God can do anything. Zagada lagada lagada. Lebagada 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 lagada. Lebagada lagada lagada. Lebagada lagada lagada. Lebagada lagada lagada. Lebagada lagada. Anything is possible. Anything is possible to them that believe it. Bible says everything is possible to them that believe it. Bible says everything is possible. Lebagada lagada lagada. 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 That thing I'm believing God for is possible now. That thing I'm trusting God for is possible now. That thing I'm believing God for is possible now. It's possible now. It's possible now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Receive it now. Ayagada lagada lagada. Lebagada 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 lagada lagada. It's your turn. 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 Receive the manifestation of God. Receive the glory of God. Receive the mighty power of God. Receive the move of God. Receive your healing. Receive your miracles. Anything is possible. Anything is possible. Anything is possible. Anything is possible. In that sickness, that's a way of escape. In that disease, that's a way of escape. In that problem, that's a way of escape. In that situation, that's a way of escape. Receive your escape. Receive your escape. Escape from trouble. Escape from problems. Escape from difficulties. Escape from sickness. Escape from foundations. It's your turn. It's your turn. It's your turn. Receive it now. Receive it now. Anything is possible. Anything. Because to everything that's a season, to everything that's a season, to everything, everything, everything. Your season of deliverance has come. Your season of healing has come. Your season of restoration has come. Receive your season. Receive your season. Receive your season. Receive your season. Your time has come. Your time has come. Your time has come. Your time has come. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh my God, the time is fast spent. I didn't even touch my scripture. I have about 500 scriptures. I want to you. I didn't even touch it. But that's how God wants it. Hallelujah. Time is so spent. But I want to say something very clearly, quickly, that you see, the first case I mentioned about people whose time is to be on the 6th of June. And then no matter what you do, it will happen to the 6th of June. I want to put a caveat on it. That if you think because God has planned to be 6th of June, you now say, okay, whatever we will be, let me go and enjoy myself. You're in trouble. I'm not going to forget it. You're very much in trouble. Because when you come and pass, you will know. You know why I said that? When they asked, I said, Jesus, when will be the time for restoration of Israel? Jesus said, don't worry, I don't know the time and season. So the only Father knows. God purposely hid these things from us. The times and season of his appearing, so we can get serious. But he will show us a sign. And I'll give you about three signs. He will give us a sign that he's around. Remember I told you three signs, right? Oh, dying hunger. Power to stay. That's what we are going through. And burden. When you see this thing around you, that means it's time for healing. Deliverance has come. But we see a man who is very like a desert. What about we be? They say God does it sometime. I wait till God does it. You're in trouble. Big one. Because when he come and pass, he wouldn't even know. And he prayed to some. A lot of people have died without receiving the manifestation. So many have died without the manifestation coming to them. Why? They missed it. God was wooing you, calling you, you refused to answer. Until it came and passed. And people remain in that state. They keep looking for solution when there's no solution until they die. They die without manifestation. Bible says that so many rich people in the grave, rich in their manifestation, rich in their healing and miracles, but they die without receiving it. Why? They missed it. So we can miss your season. So don't say because God has said he's only born in 6th of June, now begin to relax. No, that's how it works. Because you don't know. I don't know. Nobody knows. Even Jesus said, I don't know when he's coming. That means there are certain things that God has hidden from people. He hid it from Christ, talking of you. Am I communicating? That's why you should get serious. Oh God, give me the staying power. Oh, I will not give up. No matter what I see, I won't give up coming to fellowship. I won't give up praying. I won't give up fasting. I won't give up reading my Bible. Because I don't know the time and season when you come to visit me. Therefore, I will plug into it. Give me the staying power. I will not give up. Despite what I'm seeing. Despite what is going on. Power to stay despite the ups and downs, power to stay despite the inconveniences, power to stay despite the discomfort, power to stay no matter what happens, power to stay, power to move. In the name of Jesus. Friends, apart from specific manifestations, God has released general one. I told you before about the grace. Bible says the grace that bringeth salvation has appeared to all men. All men. Even as that one, you have to accept it. But some of us who have accepted that general grace, at least before your specific manifestation, you have a general manifestation. But the dispensation of grace. You can bask in it while you wait for the new one. But not to connect to the general one and then the specific one, you're in trouble. Oh, oh God, give me grace to connect. Power. in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hannah knew how to harvest this thing. A woman had was barren for years, but she went to harvest. You can see the hunger. Hunger for his presence. Lord, give me a prophet. I will give it to you. Give me somebody. Give me a baby. Give me a child. She was headlong praying. Praying herself into a specific manifestation. Hunger. Show me a man that has no hunger for his presence. I will show you a man who never received manifestation. Hunger for his presence. She went there. Others have gone home. Left her husband. Left everybody. Went to pray. Hunger for the presence. Show me a woman who is hungry for his presence. Show me a woman that God will give a prophet. Oh God, give me a prophet. Ayakada lagada lagada. Lebragada 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 lagada lagada. In Jesus' name. Friends, the third one, you see, a man of burden. Kayaba. He said, I shall see the travail of my soul. A man of burden, anything is possible to him. Anna and Simeon, they had burden for the coming of Jesus. They prayed for years. Anna prayed for years. Fasted and prayed for years. Waiting for the consolation of Israel. Eventually, because of the burden two of them carried, they were able to see the master. Am I making sense? Simeon saw the master. I said, Master, I have seen the constitution of Israel. Then your servant can go. Burden was what kept him. Burden. A man of burden will surely see his days of manifestation. Am I coming? We'll surely see the days of his appearance. Oh God, give me a body for the church, body for my family. Aso katalabaya, mali bragado sakata, ye bragado shekete lebaya. Ayanda lo bragado sekete, ye bragado salaba. Mayanda lo bragado se, ye bragado sabaya. Body, give me his body, give me body. You will see the travel of your soul. You will see the travel of your soul. You shall 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 see the trouble of your soul. Are you putting about your husband? You will see his deliverance. Are you putting about your wife? You will see her deliverance. Are you putting about the fellowship? You will see such a deliverance. Are you putting? You will see his manifestation. Every burden man will see manifestation. You shall see the trouble of your soul. You shall see the trouble of your soul. You shall see the trouble of your soul. Power of God. What is your body? In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
A man of burden, even when he goes into dry seasons, he's burdened. His body is crying. Oh God, give me one more time. Give me another time. Masuka talabayabosha. Balabosh, burden. A man of burden, even though there's a dressing around, but he knows one thing. Masuka tabaya. That my time of raining time is coming. The way I will hear the bandas of rain is on his way. He carries burden at dry season. He does not give up. But a man who has no burden during dry season is busy playing around. A man has no burden during dry season. He's been playing around until the time of rain comes and pass. But that's not your position. That's not your portion. You will pray and pray. You carry burden all the days of your life. Body for the kingdom, body for God's people, body for the family, and I see God's manifestation over your life and destiny. In the name of Jesus, receive God's manifestation. Receive God's. things that look impossible, they shall become possible for you. Receive power. Receive power. Power to defy sickness. Power to defy death. Receive it now. Every chariot after your destiny, all these double pursuers, die! The devil must go down. His God must go down. The powers of death must go down. And you will see his glory. You will see his glory. You will see his wonder. God, make a difference. In the name of Jesus.